I represent the ideas and the ideals that make us American. I also believe in the freedoms the flag represents, and the people can speak for themselves. I know this, our players respect the flag and what it represents, and we're all proud at the Ravens of the work that we do to make this community and country better. That's what John Harbaugh, in a release written statement today, said about the national anthem. We also have some reaction from the players today, and generally speaking, the players sort of said, not that big of a deal for me right now, at least from the Ravens' perspective. And look, there is a multiple different ways to kind of look at this issue, but I think one of the interesting things, at least what I think the two things that the NFL tried to accomplish yesterday coming out of the policy for the national anthem, I think they tried to come up with two things to sort of separate themselves from the issue last year. And I think the first thing that they tried to accomplish yesterday, and we can debate all day long whether or not they accomplished these two things, but I think what they tried to accomplish was they tried to absolve themselves a little bit from this as from the league perspective, from the league point of view. They decided that this is a club-by-club issue. They removed themselves from the discipline and put it into the hands of the club officials. It's sort of like when you hear in history terms or even nowadays when you talk about states' rights versus federal rights, this was a situation where the NFL decided that they would succeed some power here and cede it back to the individual clubs. And the NFL press release talked about how this was a compromise. Well, I don't know if technically a compromise was reached here, because as we'll hear from the Players Association, they weren't involved in these discussions. But Roger Goodell talking about this policy, he was talking about what exactly this policy is. We'll hear from Roger Goodell here in a second about what exactly this means for the NFL, what he's trying to accomplish with this policy. Here's Roger Goodell on the new flag policy from the NFL and exactly what the policy is.
If anyone is on the field and is disrespectful to the anthem or the flag, there would be a fine from the league against the team. The team will have its own work rules, will be consistent with the overall policy, and they will make their own decisions about how to manage that.
So there you have it, you know, the league sort of absolving themselves, putting this back into the hands of the individual clubs to make the decision as far as what they feel is the right sanctions to put on the players. And yesterday you had Christopher Johnson, the owner of the Jets, coming out already saying that if there's any sort of individual fine that's levied back to our club towards an individual, we will take care of that. Now, he's really the one owner that's kind of stepped out right now and discussed this as far as the individual owner absorbing the cost from a player showing some disrespect towards the flag. This was Goodell on what happens if somebody does, in fact, kneel during the national anthem next year in the NFL.
If anyone is on the field and is disrespectful to the anthem or the flag, there would be a fine from the league against the team. The team will have its own work rules, will be consistent with the overall policy, and they will make their own decisions about how to manage that from the club.
So there's Roger Goodell's thoughts on what the policy is, how they will try to enforce it. Let's look at the player stance on it as well. I think that's where it's also become a very interesting topic to what the players now do. How do they handle this? What are your thoughts on what Roger Goodell and the anthem policy has stated? You can call us at 410-467-WBAL. We'll take a break, come back, and look from it from the player's perspective. How do they handle this? How do they move forward? Give us your thoughts on what John Harbaugh said today, what the Ravens as a team said today. You can do that at 410-467-WBAL. You're listening to WBAL Sports Tonight on WBAL News Radio 1090.
Coming Tuesday, May 31st through Saturday, June 2nd, the 2018 Baltimore Ravens Beach Bash, presented by Miller Lite, live from Ocean City, with Jameis and Easley. Listen starting Thursday night at 7 on WBAL News Radio 1090.
WBAL News Radio 1090. Traffic and weather. Traffic is still improving this evening, but overall the picture is looking a whole lot better. Both 95 and 895 into those tunnels are all looking much better. The Bella Inner Loop remains a bit busy past Wilkins Avenue. The crash complete for the right shoulder. Off 95, there's not too much of a jam for remaining, as the rest of the Beltway does look very good. Down on the BW Parkway, special delay southbound on 97, northbound at Green Delta past Powell Road. That does remain a little bit busy. And also, do still avoid Route 1 through Perry Hall. Of course, shut down still between Chapel Road and Honeygoat Boulevard for the ongoing viewing of Officer Caprio.